Have you ever seen this equation in school and been like, what the f***? Then your teacher probably told you that this is the derivative of a function. And you're probably thinking this equation looks really weird. At least that was what I thought when I saw this the first time. In this video, I will explain why this equation looks like this and what a derivative actually is. So this equation is really weird. We have the lim, which is the limit of the equation where h goes to zero. But why does the equation look like this? And why are we taking the limit in the first place? First of all, we need to look at the definition of a derivative. The derivative of a function is a function itself that characterizes the rate of change of the original function. Okay, but what does that actually mean? It means that the derivative is a function that can describe the slope of the tangent at every point on the original function. Let's visualize this. Here we have a few random points on a graphed function. At every point we can draw a tangent line, which is a straight line that only touches the function in the points. So the derivative is a tool to find out what the slope of the tangent is at any given point on a function. This is very important. It is the slope of the tangent, not the tangent itself, the slope. At this point you might ask, why the f*** do we want to know the slope of tangent lines? Well, there are a lot of situations where this is very powerful. Some of those situations will be explained in part 2 of this video. For now, let's keep focusing on what a derivative actually is. Alright, we now know that a derivative describes the slope of a tangent, but how do we write an equation that can do this for us? The trick here is to start by making a secant line, not a tangent line. First we look at our graphed function again. Let's choose a random point on the function and call this point x, and f of x. Now let's go and amount h away from x, and make another point. This point now has the value x plus h, and f of x plus h. Now we can draw a straight line between these two points. This is called a secant line. Now let's first of all try to describe the slope of the secant line. The slope of a straight line, when you know two points on it, is the change in y divided by the change in x. We then get f of x plus h minus f of x divided by x plus h minus x. In the denominator, we can see that we have x minus x, therefore it just simplifies to h. Wait a minute. Now we have something that looks very similar to the equation for a derivative. But all we did was take the slope of a secant line, not the tangent line. We only need one more step to make this equation describe the tangent slope. Here is where that really weird limit thing comes into the picture. We now let h go towards zero. This means we have our second point travel towards the first point. And there we have it. We figured out why this weird looking equation actually somewhat makes sense. Now, when we actually have to use derivatives, we normally don't use this equation to get them. You can of course use it, but it takes a lot of time and is very tedious. There are some rules to use that makes taking derivatives a lot faster and easier. These rules will be explained in part 2 of this video, as well as some examples of where derivatives are very useful. So if you haven't yet, please subscribe so you know when part 2 of this video goes live.